Good morning. It's Thursday the 23rd of February today, and I'm just about to start packing my art prints. So these are my A5 art prints, and if you watched my previous vlog, then you'll know I was waiting on the A5 cello bags to be able to package them up. So I'm just signing the back of these now, so my little froggy art print. I'm going to put them with these A5 grey boards. So these are quite thick actually compared to what I normally go for. I normally go for, I think it's the 1000 micron. This is like 1800 micron or something like that. So it's kind of almost double the thickness of what I go for. But it was okay price wise, and it just means that they're even more sturdy in these bags. I'm feeling quite tired today, so I don't know how much filming I'll be able to get done, because as much as I love filming, it does... What I'm going to do, I think, well, that's going to be really annoying. So what I'll do is I will package them, and then I'll do the peeling after I've done this intro. You don't have to listen to that horrible noise. I am going to package these up this morning, and then I think I'll probably spend the day doing quite a lot of admin, because as I say, I'm really quite tired, and I know that it will take its toll on me. Unfortunately, these A5 bags, because I went for C5, because I thought that's what I needed when I package A5 items, they are really quite a bit bigger, which doesn't, I'm not keen on that, if I'm honest. I prefer it when they are nice and snug. I don't know how I feel about that. It's quite frustrating. I'm not sure whether I should fold that over and use a sticker on the back, or... Decisions. As you can see, I get quite distracted quite easily. I'm just using my old branding stickers at the moment. They are different to the ones that I have my new branding. So that's my new branding, my current branding for 2023, as you can see here. But I've got quite a few of these left over from previous years. So I'm just going to use these on the A5 prints because they're nice and small in comparison to this size. So I think I'm just going to use these on here. I am going to spend most of the day doing admin, as I said, and then I will see what other things I feel like I'm up to doing today. I really, really don't know what will be interesting enough to be filmed, but we shall see. I would like to do a couple more. I'd like to do a couple more arty videos. I'd like to get the supplies out and do some painting maybe, so that would be quite fun to get some watercolour painting done. So if I feel like the shop is quiet, because it's actually quite a rainy day today, if the shop goes quiet, then I'll probably spend some time doing some artwork, and then yeah, we'll see how we go through the day and see what interesting things I can share with you. I don't know how much of the sort of the mundane boring you want to see really. I mean, obviously there's a lot more involved in running a shop than just all the aesthetics things that you see, or the things that are easy for me to share with you. So there's things like all of the loading things onto the website, there's the VAT paperwork, the accounts paperwork, there's the stock taking and the ordering, and yeah, there's quite a lot involved in running the physical shop as well as the online side of things. So I'd love to know what sort of things you'd like to see in these studio vlogs. I'm quite happy continuing as I am and just filming bits and pieces through the day for you to see, all the bits that I think are a bit more interesting or creative based. But if you are interested in any of the behind the scenes of physical shop running, let me know and I shall add them into the vlog. But for now, I'm going to get on with packing these A5 orders, these A5 prints, and loading them onto the website, popping them out in the shop for sale, and seeing how they go. I really hope they do well. I think actually I've converted to liking the borders. Originally, I was quite concerned about not being able to have borderless on A5s, but I think it works really quite well. And obviously, if they're going to go into a frame, then usually the frame is slightly smaller anyway, so it kind of works. But yeah, I think these look quite nice with the white border around them. And I think A5 is a nice size to have as like something for people to purchase when they're browsing the shop. So we'll see how they go in the shop. And when I load them onto the website and my Etsy, we'll see how they go there too. let's get on with the day. Currently doing some really boring admin tasks, so nothing fun to show you at the moment, but they've all got to be done. The website has to be updated every time new products come in and every time prices change, which is quite regularly at the moment, because obviously if the price goes up on what we're buying it in at and then I don't change the website and people buy like a lot of a product at a much lower price than what we should be selling it at, we're going to be making a loss. So it's boring and mundane work, but it has to be done, so I'm going to get on with that, and I won't film too much of that because you'll get bored of watching the same process over and over again. But I'll show you what it's like outside at the moment. It's not very nice, so I'm guessing it's going to be quite a quiet day. We've had a few people in buying books and things like that, but I think it's going to be quite quiet today because it's a bit miserable out there, so it will give me a chance to get on with a lot of the admin tasks. But yeah. Morning. It's Friday the 24th of February and it is freezing. It's so cold. I was not expecting to be back into these sorts of cold temperatures. I think, to be fair, it's showing as 10.9 in here at the moment, so temperature's just there, but it's showing as 10.9 at the moment, but it feels so cold and the windows are all frosted up like they get the condensation, and they only get like that when it gets really really cold. So usually by the end of February it's warmed up enough for that to not happen, but for some reason it has dropped in temperature again, so it's really really cold and I'm struggling again. So I've got the radiator back out the cupboard because I had put the radiator away, but I've got it back out the cupboard now and I've got my gloves warming up on the radiator because it's just so cold. I have quite a lot to do today. One of the things I want to do today is to have a go at printing on these. So if you've watched my previous studio vlogs, you'll have seen that I got my Mumbin thermal labour printer and I'm really pleased with how that's going. Although I did buy some labels that were sort of the wrong green shade. So I've sent those back. They were really lovely. They gave me a refund on those ones and I ordered these instead. And these are a sort of light grey. They didn't have the mint green that I would have liked, so this is like a light grey colour, which is fine because my colours are kind of like the colours you can see on the door behind me. So those are my branding colours for Artanddesignbykb, so these will work fine for that. These are also great for branding of my Devon Art Supplies business and Betty's Books business because the grey shade comes in both of those brandings as well. So I'm going to experiment today and see if I can get the hang of printing the thermal label stickers on the circular designs. I pre-did some designs on Procreate
and fired them over to Canva to get the settings right for saving them and things like that, and hopefully I'll be able to load those up and get those printed today. What else is on my to-do list? I really want to improve the interaction on my Etsy. I feel like my Etsy account, well, all of my Etsy accounts, I have multiple. So there's Mrs. K.A. Betty for sort of my personal and studio life and things like that. That's what I've always had. I've had that one since I remember loading up to Insta. Then I have one for Devon Art Supplies, I have one for Betty's Books, and I have one for Art and Design by KB, but none of them have ever been successful. I've never been able to get any traction, any interaction, and, you know, sales or anything at all from Etsy. So it's just not been one of the channels that I've focused on social media wise. But this year, I would really like to build on the Art and Design by KB Instagram, improve it, learn how to improve it. So I'm going to look for courses. If you have any recommendations for courses on improving social media, let me know in the comments, because I'm really interested in going on some courses, online ones obviously, to learn how to better use Instagram and Facebook. TikTok, fine. I sort of got popular on TikTok, reasonably popular on TikTok very quickly, and I actually enjoy TikTok, so it's not so much of a hassle, whereas Instagram, I don't enjoy it. I feel like it's, if you're not aesthetically pleasing 24/7 and perfect and pristine, you're not going to get any interaction or any traction on Instagram, and I don't feel like I'm that sort of person. I'm not able to take constant photos all day of things that look always aesthetically pleasing. I have learned that I can use certain apps to tweak my products and designs and make them look a bit more aesthetically pleasing for posts and things, so I have been doing that. I've been working on using my images and my product photos within other designs and putting that on Instagram, and so if you do follow me on Instagram, you will have noticed I've started working harder on making things look nicer, and this app that I'm using has worked really well to help me to do that, so I'm going to do a lot more of that. And yeah, it's a difficult one really, because it's not just where you spend your time to get the interaction, it's where you spend your time where you enjoy working too, because if you don't enjoy doing it, I find that often you don't put enough effort in for it to work out anyway. So for example, I've just relaunched my Patreon, and if you don't know about what that is, I'll put the link down below and you can click and have a little look at the tiers that I'm offering over on Patreon. Now Patreon I absolutely love, because over there what I'm going to be doing is sharing my experience as a small business owner and shop owner, so it'll be all the behind the scenes information. I'll be happy to answer questions, I'll be offering tips, tricks and advice on what it's like running a small business, physical store and online and things like that. And so it's something that I enjoy sharing that information. I absolutely love doing YouTube videos, I love filming them for you, I love editing them, so they don't feel as drawn out a task for the business as things like Instagram do. Facebook, hit and miss with Facebook over the years. I do use it and do promote on there when I can, but it's not massively drawing people in, so it's hard to know, I would say. It's hard to know where your time is best spent when it comes to social media and marketing and promoting your small business. Because I have the high street shop, I'm quite lucky in some senses that people are finding me by coming in store, and then they're getting to know me and getting to chat about all the different things they see in store. So if they're interested in the books, then I'll direct them to the Betty's Book social media. If they're interested in the art supplies, it'll be the Devon Art Supply social media. And if they like my artwork, or they like to learn about the things and that I'm designing and things like that, then it will be the Art and Design by KB social media that I'm going to direct them to. So having the shop has been the main thing for me to get my name out there, to get all of my social media found. Having the shop has been a massive part of that. And also going to markets. I used to go to markets quite regularly. So I would do different shows and markets, Bath and West, West Point, all sorts of different places. There are so many more, but they're so long ago now that I can't remember. But markets helped massively as well to get the name out there for my businesses. And yeah, social media is just one of my, it works, but it could be so much better and I need to put a lot more effort into it. So social media is one of the things I'm gonna be working really hard on this year. So if you have any advice or tips or tricks, or if you are a vlogger that talks about social media and how to improve it for your small business, let me know.
morning. It's Thursday the 2nd of March and I haven't popped on to say hello for a couple of days, and that is because I am so poorly right now. I'm suffering with a cold that my children have passed on to me, and I just feel really grotty and really horrible, but I am going to do my best. Sorry, let me just turn off this beeping sound a second. I'm getting lots of notifications on my computer. So I'm going to do my best to film some more content for you so that I can wrap this vlog up by the end of this week and start fresh again next week. And one of the things I'm excited to share with you today is my first Patreon post. So I have subbed as a Patreon to 3 content makers. I'd love to sub to loads more, and there are 2 others that I really want to sub to, but I decided to go for the slightly smaller accounts to try and support the smaller ones. So there's a brand new one who is Prints by Millie, and she is a YouTuber that I came across, and then I found her on Instagram after that, and then I decided to become a Patreon of hers so straight away as soon as she opened her Patreon. So that's one of the ones, and I'm on the tier where you get a freebie. I also am part of Rebels, so I think it's Rebel Jones, but I will add the links to these 3 accounts down below so you can follow them and become patrons if you like as well. So I've also joined her group, and I am part of like a chat group on there, which is lovely, and it's like a supportive community of small business owners and creatives. And then the other person is Coco, and I don't know how to say this, so I'm gonna say it wrong, Coco Natasha. And again, another YouTuber that I follow for a while now, really enjoy the vlogs and decided to go and support her over on Patreon. And I'm on one of the higher tiers at the moment this month for her. And I just wanted to get one of the goodie boxes because they looked really great, and I didn't know what to buy from her website. So I thought, I know, I'll join her Patreon, join one of the higher tiers, get a really good goodie box. And then if I can afford it, stay on that tier. If I can't, I'll downgrade the tier for her one down to one of the lower ones like the other 2 accounts. And then I will potentially join a smaller, lower tier of a couple of other creators as well. So I just want to support other creatives, as well as obviously being a creative myself. I feel it's really important that I support others that inspire me or that I really find interesting. And so those are 3 of the top ones that I love. I also watch Catnip Studios, but she's massively well known here on YouTube, and also Emily Harvey, and both of those I'd love to become patrons soon. And I watch all of their content on YouTube and things like that, so, but they're massively well known, so you've probably already heard of them. Yeah, so I obviously opened my Patreon officially on the 1st of March. Now, I don't have a very big Instagram following, and I knew that was going to impact the fact that I wouldn't be able to get Patreon straight away the way that the other accounts do. And so I opened my Patreon yesterday on March the 1st officially. I did a soft launch the week before that just to sort of get myself used to promoting it, and nobody joined. And that's is as expected, because I just don't have an online following. Everything I've been doing for the past 10 years has been focused here in my physical shop. And so I haven't spent enough time online, on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. I haven't learned how to connect with you guys enough that you will want to follow me and join me as patrons yet. And I understand that and I respect that. And I just hope that given time, that you guys will see the value and the worth of following me here on YouTube and subscribing to my channel here and watching my content and then potentially joining me over on Patreon, because I'd absolutely love to have a group of people who are creatives and small business owners, or just people that are interested in what it's like running a high street shop, what it's like being a creative. And I've got 10 years worth of experience to share. I've got so much that I can help you guys with. So if you are aspiring to own a shop, then you get to ask me questions and you get to have one-to-one chats with me, and I can help you in how to set up. And I just think that I have a lot to share. And so that's why I've opened the Patreon. And as I say, I'm totally understanding that no one has joined my Patreon yet. And it's realistic, you know, everyone out there, you're not all going to get people joining your Patreon on the first few days or weeks or months even of opening up a Patreon if you haven't got that sort of close-knit following that you need to have. And I think usually that's on Instagram as well, because I have quite big accounts on Facebook. So my Imagine Design Create account is massive on Facebook. I've got over 5,000 followers on there, but I don't see the interaction. I don't get the comments. I don't get the likes that we used to get over there. And so I have decided to focus more time on Instagram this year, on each of my accounts, especially Art and Design by KB. And I'm going to really work hard to connect with people and let them know who I am, what I do, and why I think what I have to offer is worth listening to and worth watching. So yeah, without going on any further, I'm gonna open Millie's post. So we're gonna open it. There we go. So let's see what we get. So inside, if I just open it up, it looks a bit like this. So obviously we've got her business card. And then we've got the sticker that you get as a Patreon. So yeah, there we go, that's what you get. And no note this time. Usually when I sign up to things, you get like a personal note or something, but no note this time, but a beautiful sticker and a business card telling me about how to connect with Millie online. So thank you very much, Millie, if you're watching. And I will choose a home for this. It's green as well, so it goes with my studio vibe, which is fantastic. I'm gonna find a home for this beautiful sticker. And yeah, I'm really excited to see what I can learn from all the other creatives, because the creatives that I followed, they are online creatives, and a lot of what they do has been online for the years. So although I've had 10 years owning a business and running a business, everything I know, I would say, is about owning a physical shop and a website. In terms of social media, I've got so much to learn, and that is why I am following those that are inspiring me, supporting them by being a patron of their accounts, and fingers crossed that will help me to understand and learn how to connect more with you guys watching and with everybody on Instagram and social media, so that you guys can find me and be able to support me as a creator too. So let's get on with the day. Thank you.